New Zealand estimates damage of up to $8 billion in the aftermath of Cyclone Gabriel. That storm hit the island's northernmost region February 12, leaving 11 dead and around 3,000 missing. Prime Minister Chris Hipkins extended the national state of emergency for one more week to bolster recovery and relief efforts. The government announced emergency funding of 300 million New Zealand dollars, with 250 million dedicated to repairing critical roads and 50 million set aside for businesses and primary producers. Finance Minister Grant Robertson has also been appointed Cyclone Recovery Minister as the country works to recover from what Hipkins calls New Zealand's biggest natural disaster this century. The Philippine team that's part of the Turkey contingent has so far treated more than 600 quake victims in Adiyaman Province. According to the Office of Civil Defense, the group's operations center is open round the clock. And aside from affected residents, the medical team also monitors the condition of other members of the contingent. Currently, the urban search and rescue team has cleared 38 collapsed buildings and recovered 4 bodies. The 82-member response team is currently on standby and waiting for requests for assistance from the local emergency management agency.
Mga patients po ng mga dumarating dito, pinatreads namin, then binabato namin sa mga proper doctors kung sino yung mga maghahawak sa kanila. At the same time, kung kailangan na siyang i-transfer, makastanday naman yung mga ambulance natin from the Ministry of Health dito. Kaya meron po kasi tayong mga kasamang OB. Marami na rin siyang natingnan ng mga OB patients at this time. So yung iba, na i-transfer na rin natin kasi mas kailangan nila ng higher facility.
Meta Platforms, borrowing from Twitter's playbook, the parent company of Facebook and Instagram, is set to test a monthly subscription service that will give paying users a blue badge. All they would need is a government ID to have their accounts verified. But the subscription service will include extra protection against impersonation. Meta Verified will be priced starting at $11.99 per month on the web or $14.99 a month on Apple's iOS system and Android. It will first be rolled out in Australia and New Zealand starting this week. Maritime tensions between the Philippines and China taking the spotlight at a high-level security conference in Germany. Manila's top diplomat Enrique Manalo says Beijing's harassment has become a daily situation being faced by Filipino fishermen and the country's Coast Guard. He now says the international community's support for the arbitral victory of the Philippines can serve as an anchor for a rules-based maritime regime in the South China Sea. Manalo's remarks follow China's laser use on a Philippine vessel near Ayungin Shoal, an incident that drew international condemnation and a strong denial from Beijing. Back here at home, a maritime law expert welcomes the Philippine government's move of raising Manila's maritime dispute with Beijing at the security conference in Germany. Professor Jay Batumbacal hopes the Marcos administration will be consistent in showing a strong stance on the row.
There's a lot more openness and transparency, which is a good thing. Precisely the reason why China has been able to get away with a lot of things is that the previous administration cooperated with it in hiding events and downplaying them. So this policy of immediately reporting what has happened really should be done. Hopefully this will be the standing policy of the administration, and that will help us certainly in discouraging China from taking more provocative actions in the future.
Batumbacal now urges government to shore up more international support to the Philippine side.
The logical next step really is to keep on pushing back, keep on with the transparency, keep on with the reportage, the reporting on events with a bit more transparency and with the support of the international community that gives China pause. We should work actually with the other claimant countries in coming up with a coordinated response now to these kinds of activities by China, and also to promote again greater transparency even in what's going on in their part of the South China Sea.